हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर पी आर चौधरी फ्रॉम केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द न्यू ट्रेंड्स इन फूड साइंस एंड न्यूट्रिशन अंडर द कोर्स प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ फूड साइंस एंड न्यूट्रिशन, कोर्स नंबर FST 362। वी विल बी मेनली स्टडिंग द न्यू मेथड्स और टेक्नोलॉजीज ऑफ प्रोसेसिंग, नेमली हाई प्रेशर प्रोसेसिंग, पल्स इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड प्रोसेसिंग, ओमिक हीटिंग, अल्ट्रासाउंड प्रोसेसिंग, कोल्ड प्लाज्मा टेक्नोलॉजी एंड एनकैप्सुलेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। हाई प्रेशर प्रोसेसिंग इज अ प्रॉमिसिंग नॉन थर्मल फूड प्रिजर्वेशन प्रोसेस दैट इनएक्टिवेट्स हार्मफुल बैक्टेरियल एंड फूड स्पॉयलेज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड इट हैज़ बीन रिकग्नाइज एज वन ऑफ द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर द नेक्स्ट डेकेड। High pressure processing, also called as high pressure pascalization or cold pasteurization, uses only cold water and extreme pressure to safely and naturally preserve food and beverage products. As a result, there are no added preservatives or harsh chemicals involved in this method. Now let us first understand how high pressure processing works. High pressure processing involves loading of airtight or hermetically sealed packages into carrier baskets. The baskets are then inserted into high pressure processing vessels and it is then sealed by plugs. After this, potable water is pumped into the vessel, creating isostatic pressure that is equal pressure on all sides of the packages. The product is held at high pressure of 300 to 600 megapascal or 43,000 to 87,000 psi for up to 6 minutes. The pressure and the time will vary according to the product. After this, the product comes out of the vessel and is ready to be refrigerated until consumed. The effect of high hydrostatic pressure, unlike other thermal processes, is almost instantaneous and uniform. The effects are independent of shape and size of the product and equipment used. The pressure disrupts the microbial biochemistry of pathogens and spoilage bacteria, which helps to preserve freshness and increase shelf life. It does not cause shear stress damage because equal pressure is exerted on the food from all directions. High hydrostatic pressure inactivates the vegetative flora including bacteria, virus, yeast, mold and parasite present in the food, thus extending the product shelf life and guaranteeing food safety. Here we can see the product is placed in the basket and inserted into the vessel. The vessel will fill with water and it will exert the isostatic pressure equally on the package. The pressure will range from 300 to 600 megapascal or 43,000 to 87,000 psi. Hydrostatic pressure helps to deactivate the microbial pathogens. Afterwards, the package is brought outside and it is further stored or packed off. This is the actual high pressure processing equipment. Here you can see the basket in which the products will be placed and the high pressure processing chamber. The main benefits of using high pressure processing are: it enhances the food safety. High pressure processing destroys pathogens and drastically reduces the overall microbiological spoiling flora. So using high pressure processing, almost 5 log reduction of pathogens can be achieved. Usually 1 log reduction means the number of pathogens is 10 times smaller, while 5 log reduction means the number of pathogen is 10 raised to 5 times or 1 lakh times smaller. That is, it will be equal to 99.99% microbial reduction in rate. It also extends the shelf life to almost 2 to 10 times longer. In addition, it avoids or reduces the need for food preservatives and chemicals, thus enabling clean label foods, which are natural and free from any additives. Next, since it increases the shelf life, it helps to reduce food waste and improve the end channel profitability. High pressure processing retains the sensorial and nutritional properties of food because of the absence of heat treatment, and it maintains its original freshness throughout the shelf life. Therefore, we obtain products of greater food quality, having natural taste, texture, and nutritional value. The products that cannot be treated thermally can also be treated using high pressure processing. And in the end, it protects the brand reputation or company reputation, since it decreases the risk of product recalls due to microbial outbreak. Pulsed electric field is another emerging technology, which is a non-thermal mild food processing technology suitable for preserving liquid and semi-liquid food products. This processing method uses short electric pulses to achieve microbial inactivation in food products while preserving the fresh characteristics. In this technology is considered superior to traditional thermal processing methods because it avoids or greatly reduces detrimental changes in the sensory and physical properties of food. It aims to offer consumers high quality food. Pulse electric field usually kills microorganisms while better maintaining the original color, flavor, texture, and nutritional value of the food product. Pulse electric field technology involves the application of microsecond pulses of high voltage ranging from 10 to 60 kilowatts to liquid or semi-solid foods placed between two electrodes. The treatment is applied continuously in a chamber which includes setup of multiple electrodes. In this chamber, the product is exposed to high voltage pulses and the required treatment time is less than a second. The pulses are applied at repetition rates of up to 1000 per second to allow sufficient treatment of all volume elements. The short electric pulses introduce a potential difference between the inside and outside of the cell membrane of microorganisms, and this will induce pores in the cell membrane, leading to loss of the barrier function and leakage of the intracellular content and loss of vitality. Because of this, the microorganisms can be deactivated by this method. Loss of cell membrane barrier function causes the microbial death. The process is quick, flexible, energy efficient, and because heat is minimized, products have a longer shelf life while maintaining better nutritional value than the traditional processing techniques. In addition, pulse electric field does not affect vitamins, flavors, or proteins. This allows microbial decontamination of heat-sensitive liquid while retaining their sensory qualities and functional values. Usually, solid, semi-liquid, and liquid foods can be treated using pulse electric field. For heat-sensitive liquid foods, where thermal pasteurization is not an option, this method can be used for treatment. The next method is ohmic heating. Ohmic heating is an advanced thermal processing method wherein the food material serves as an electrical resistor and is heated by passing electricity through it. Electrical energy is dissipated into heat, which results in rapid and uniform heating of the food. Ohmic heating is also called as electrical resistance heating, joule heating, or electroheating, and it can be used for variety of application in food industry. Like thermal processing, ohmic heating inactivates microorganisms by heat. However, during conventional thermal processing, significant product quality damage may occur due to slow conduction and convection heat transfer. Ohmic heating volumetrically heats the entire mass of food material rapidly and uniformly, thus resulting product is of far greater quality. In addition, in ohmic heating, it is possible to process large particulate foods up to 1 inch in size that would be difficult to process under conventional heating methods. Here you can see the ohmic heating instrument, where you have these insulator caps and the electrodes will be connected to these ends, and you have the insulator tubes or pipes. Here the diameter of the pipe is 80 millimeter, and through these pipes the food will be passed and it will act as a barrier or resistance and get heated. Ohmic heating can be used for heating liquid foods containing large particulates such as soup, stews, fruit slices in syrup and sauces, and heat sensitive liquid. The technology is useful for treatment of proteinaceous food, which tend to denature and coagulate when thermally processed. Example, liquid egg can be ohmically heated in a fraction of a second without coagulating it. Juices can be treated to inactivate enzymes without affecting the flavor. The other potential applications of ohmic heating include blanching, thawing, fermentation, peeling, dehydration, and extraction. The shelf life of ohmically processed foods is comparable to that of canned and sterile aseptically processed products. The next method is ultrasound processing. Ultrasound is defined as sound waves with frequencies over the threshold of human hearing, that is 16 to 20 kilohertz, which are able to travel through gas, liquid, and solid materials. When these waves travel in liquid media, alternate compression and rarefaction cycles are produced. The waves cause formation of air or vapor bubbles. These vapor bubbles keep on increasing in size or keep on growing until they reach a point where they cannot absorb more energy and they will implode violently. This creates energy release and local high temperature and pressure points, and also generates mechanical forces resulting in the breaking and shearing of cell walls. The formation and evolution of these bubbles is known as cavitation. In these cavitational hotspots, locally extreme forces create physical conditions which result in mixing or homogenization, extraction, and increased mass transfer. Ultrasonic food processing is based on the acoustic cavitation and its hydrodynamic shear forces. It can be used for microbial inactivation, food preservation, manipulation of food texture, and food analysis. The principal aim of this technology is to reduce the processing time, save energy, improve the shelf life and quality of food products. The most common application in food industry include cell destruction and extraction of intracellular materials, एक्टिवेशन और डीएक्टिवेशन ऑफ एंजाइम्स, मिक्सिंग एंड होमोजेनाइजेशन, इमल्सिफिकेशन, डिस्पर्शन, प्रिजर्वेशन, स्टेबिलाइजेशन, डिसोल्यूशन एंड क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. इट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर टेंडराइजेशन ऑफ मीट. इट कैन कंट्रोल राइपनिंग, एजिंग प्रोसेस एंड इंड्यूस ऑक्सीडेशन. The next method is cold plasma technology. Over the past decade, cold plasma or non-thermal plasma has gained significant interest for use as a non-thermal technology for food processing and safety. Cold plasma is a quasi-neutral ionized gas that comprises of highly reactive species including positive ions, negative ions, free radicals, electrons, excited or non-excited molecules, and photons at or near room temperature. Plasma can be generated using any kind of energy which can ionize the gases, such as electrical, thermal, optical, that is UV light, radioactive, such as gamma radiation, and X-ray electromagnetic radiation. However, electric or electromagnetic fields are widely used for cold plasma generation in food industry. The novelty of cold plasma technology lies with its non-thermal, economical, versatile, and environmentally friendly nature. It has been employed in the food industry for inactivation of microorganisms on the surface of fresh and processed foods, with minimal heat-induced damage of the food products. In addition to food decontamination, other potential applications include pasteurization of liquid food products, enzyme inactivation, disinfection of plant processing equipment and packaging material, toxin removal, and wastewater treatment. The most commonly used devices in food industry for generation of plasma are dielectric barrier discharge and jet plasma device. In the dielectric barrier discharge, it consists of two metal electrodes where at least one of the electrode is covered with a dielectric barrier. This dielectric barrier acts as a stabilizing material, avoiding any arc transition, and it helps to create a large number of micro discharges for homogeneous treatments. Here you can see a dielectric barrier discharge and how it creates a homogeneous discharge of plasma. Whereas in plasma jet device, it consists of two concentric electrodes where the inner electrode is typically connected to a radio frequency power at high frequency, and it causes ionization of the working gas. There is a gas inlet, and this electrode will cause ionization of the gas, and which will exit the nozzle and give a jet-like appearance. Here you can see this is a jet plasma. It looks like a jet appearance, and the food product will get disinfected over here. And the last method we'll study today is encapsulation technology. Encapsulation is a technique by which the sensitive ingredients are packed within a coating or protective wall material with the aim to preserve organoleptic and physicochemical properties of the original product, as well as it improves the palatability of volatile odorous ingredients. It provides protection against adverse reaction and controls release of the ingredients. Encapsulation of flavors and aromas is a rapidly expanding process in food industry. In addition, encapsulation process can convert liquids into powders which are easy to handle. There are two types of encapsulation. First is microencapsulation. It is envelopment of small solid particles, liquid droplets or gases in a coating within size of 1 to 1000 micrometers. Microencapsulation can be successfully applied to entrap natural compounds like essential oils, flavors, or vegetal extracts containing polyphenols with well-known antimicrobial properties. The second method is nanoencapsulation. A nanoparticle is a small particle that ranges between 1 to 100 nanometers in size, and it is mainly used for delivery of bioactive compounds in the body. The delivery of any bioactive compound to various sites within the body is directly affected by the particle size. Thus, nanoparticles being smaller as compared to microparticles, they have potential to enhance bioavailability, improve control release, and enable precision targeting of bioactive compounds to a greater extent. In addition to nanoencapsulation, nanoparticles or nanotechnology is also used for food safety as well as food preservation. In food safety, they are used for detection of foodborne pathogens, against heavy metal reduction, they are used against allergens, used against pesticides, additives and drugs, and for inhibition of biofilm formation. Whereas for food preservation, they are used as antimicrobial agents, and already we have studied the nanoencapsulation. They are also used for enhancement in physical properties and protection against chemical deteriorates. So, we have completed the novel or new trends in food science and nutrition. Thank you.